Hello and welcome to another video about the plum butter. Now I prepared a simple patch with three different sounds, and I'm going to go through the patch. And it's an opportunity, I thought, this time to talk about some things that we didn't talk on the previous two videos. One is the sequencer and the other one is the deer horn. As you can see, the lights are activated by my movement here. We'll see how does it sound like. Okay, so first let's go through the patch slowly. First sound is a nice kick from this gong. It's just the most simple thing you can do with a gong. You just send it a trigger or a pulse from the sequencer and you activate it. What you hear, the echo of the kick, is external effects that I'm using in order to give it a little bit more interesting tone. If I take the effects out, you hear it's just a meaty, really thick kick. I really like it. Back with the effects. Further, next sound is going to be the two Aviducks, a nice drone. I chose to send triggers from different steps of the sequencer in order to make the movement from left to right and the rhythmical pattern from the drone to be more interesting, that it's not always the same and that it doesn't always follow the kick in the same way constantly. And something else that is important here is that I'm also sending from the outputs of the sequencer, I'm also sending into this input blue inputs. Here I'm sending it in the normal one, and here I'm sending it on the inversed blue input. That creates a movement that's a little bit more complex, let's say. Now, further, and the magic of this patch comes from the deer horn. I'll open the volume, and then I need, of course, to fades out by itself. So this is a beautiful sound. We have two oscillators here. One is activated from this movement and one is activated from that movement here. And I found a beautiful tip in one of the forums about this instrument, that if you send the gray output from this snare section or noise section into the blue inputs here on the mixer of the deer horn, you can put this white noise into the sound of the oscillators and they sound majestic. With a little bit of noise you can hear it. It's beautiful. And you can determine, of course, the amount of noise you put here. For example, here there is no noise audible. It starts here. So you have more noise in the middle. Depends how much you like it. Okay, great. This was the patch, really quick. Now, let's talk a little bit about the sequencer. The sequencer is a very special one, so you need two things to make it work. Let's say three things that you need to do in order to make it work. Now, the first one is you need to send it a clock, let's say a pulse or a trigger from the rolls. I'm sending it from the orange output from these three rolls. and this way it knows the clock. Another important fact is you need, if you want the sequencer to loop and to continue playing, you need to connect the last step or one of the steps. You don't need to have 8 steps. You can have less if you want, 7 steps, 5 steps if you want to make it irregular. You need to connect the last step that you want into the purple input, and that's the way to make the sequencer go in a loop. Now, and then the third step is to enter notes, let's say to enter data into the sequencer steps. You need to use the red button. Don't push it once, push it and hold it till you see a light going there, and then you entered a step into the sequencer. This way you can enter more, and of course they don't have to be in a row. I have 2 going together and 1 that follows a little bit later. And this white button does the opposite, it takes the steps out of your sequence. So I hope it's clear. Now, I also triggered here the snare, but I didn't really like it. It doesn't really fit with this pad. You hear it, it's a little bit, yeah. Maybe if I can find a way to create an interesting, weird rhythm that is not connected with what's happening with the rest, that makes it interesting to use. I also didn't use this part, the ultrasound part, at all on this patch. I just wanted to keep it simple, so step by step we get deeper into this instrument, studying every part separately. Now, as you could see here, the deer horn, very beautiful, didn't patch anything. You don't have to patch anything, it just works. Of course, you need to tune it, so you have this tuning part here, which is very sensitive, and you need to you really need to listen very well in order to tune it. And especially if you have another drone going on from another part, like I have here from the AVDog, it took me a while to do the tuning. But of course, yeah, when you tune with your ears, it's just you can create these beautiful tones that, and harmonies that you think are beautiful, and you don't care about which note it is. Now, the details here are, yeah, still I haven't found a way to use and patch the deer horn. It's complicated. Of course, I know that these purple inputs are modulation, FM modulation inputs, so you can start modulating the frequency of the two oscillators, that's clear. I just didn't find a way to make this something interesting with them. Let's see what else is interesting about the deer horn. For example, we know from the previous videos that the red red means pulse out. So every time you playing that oscillator, you create also a pulse that you can do. Connect it with something else from the plum button. The orange, though, although it's supposed to be a CV out, I have here somewhere that says that orange is supposed to be an output, but users have discovered that it can act as an input in some cases. So there are a few tips online that you can follow, but I wanted to keep this patch simple, this video also that doesn't go very long. So the only beautiful thing that I'm doing here is that I'm patching the gray output from this noise snare into the top input of the deer horn. Anything else about the sequence? Yes, let's finish with that. Now, the sequencer has 2 different color outputs. This is the red outputs and the orange outputs, 4 and 4. Now, I'm reading from my notes. The red jacks are pulse outputs suitable for jerking brown geometries or triggering gongs. So it tells you this is good connected to brown inputs or triggering gongs, which means the trigger inputs on the gongs, which I'm doing actually on this patch. Further, the orange jacks are more like square waveforms, so not square waveforms but more like it, and they reflect the state of the sequencer at that point. Since a VDOG is triggered by slow resonances, it will respond better to the orange jacks. So, important thing to know, orange jacks and AVDOGs, they make a good connection, and that's why I patched the trigger input from the AVDOGs from the orange outputs here. And the last thing, it says that the orange jacks, they have more meat on them when they are on, rather than being a quick pulse. Maybe that means that they have, like, if we can call a trigger or a pulse a very, very short gate, maybe the orange outputs, they do have a little bit longer, so it's better to create this kind of drony sounds, that it kind of not for percussive sounds but more for the oscillators are better to trigger oscillators. Now I think this is enough for now. Okay, I hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.